So whenever I go through security at the airport, I keep that in mind. And I always opt out of radiation. Even if they tell me it's safe, I'm like, you think that pasta is not. I always opt out of radiation at the airport, in life in general. That's one of my policies. I opt out. At the airport, if you opt out of radiation, they say you have to do this other thing. Oh, what's that? You get your genitals touched. Well, here's the good news about that. That's something I opt into in life in general. Here's me. Here's my impression of me. You want your, you want radiation? No, thank you. Want your genitals touched? Probably. Why? What's this for? Yeah, absolutely. Go for it. Hit it. I mean, don't hit it. Just let's talk about it. What's, oh, I get to fly? Pretty great. Pretty great. This is my experience at the airport. I get to fly, I get no radiation, I get my genitals touched, and bonus, the guy doing it probably does not want to, so I win. And I don't know how you guys score your time at the airport, but I'm ahead of this guy. He's always like, sir, you know you don't have to do this. And I'm always like, sir, you know you do have to do this. Optional, mandatory. This is where we've got to in our lives. I'm a man telling a man to touch my genitals. You're a man who is being told he must or he's fired, I assume. Very few jobs have that. Airport, brothel, penis doctor. Those are the only ones. It's part of the deal. You think the Wright brothers had any idea when they invented the airplane just how many people's genitals would get touched as a direct result of their actions? I bet they thought two. Two people's genitals. The Wright brothers. That's who they thought. They're like, we just invented a flying machine. People are going to be lining up to touch them. Right, brother? They did that for fun a lot. And if they didn't, they were wasting an opportunity. So I'm at the airport. The guy's giving me the spiel. He's like, I'm going to go up your leg till I feel resistance. I'm like, I'm not going to resist at all. This is for our nation's security. If there's a terrorist in there, find him. I want to know as much, if not more, than you. Probably more. I want to know more. Get in there. Find out. Hold my balls for our country, please. This guy didn't love my balls or our country. He only made it up to like my knee, barely touching the tip of my dick. And so the whole rest of it could have been filled with an explosive liquid. It is. Boom. Ladies, that's my impression of a comedian who says things like that. And one time a guy yelled out at that point, "You wish!" And I'll answer him now because I don't believe he's here. That's how I like my confrontations. If a fight needs to happen, I'll be like, you want to take this outside? Then he goes outside, I close and lock the door behind him. Fight smarter, not harder. Like, I mean, if there's an injustice being done, I will right a wrong. If I see like a woman being picked on by, say, a smaller woman, then I will go over and say, excuse me, miss, you looked even smaller from over there. Have a nice day. Goodbye. A pleasure. But this guy yelled out, you wish. And I'll tell you, I don't wish. I don't wish my penis went to my knee, because I've never met a lady whose vagina went to her sternum. Do you know what I mean? I don't know. How would you fit into... Men get emails all the time, every day. They're like, hey, do you want your dick to be bigger, thicker, wider, hung more like a horse? Hung like a horse? Of course, of course. Thank you. That's a joke for the Wilbur Theater. Anyway. I say that wherever I go, and they're always like, where, who, we don't care. But finally. Women, on the other hand, I don't believe ever receive emails. Hey, do you want your vagina to be bigger, thicker, wider, like a cavern, taller, like it'll fit a man horse penis? No, no, thank you. Well then, who are these horse penises going into? They're only gonna fit actual horses. That's what men have to look forward to with a horse-sized penis. Why the long face? That's because of the long dick. I didn't realize. I was gonna have to put it into a horse vagina.